The 1987 Labatt Canada Cup officially got underway in Hartford, Connecticut. It was the United States squad of National Hockey League players against Finland, who had to rely mostly on their star goalie, Kari Kako. But even his antics couldn't save his national squad. Finesse the Finns didn't have, but they were scrappy, and although outscored in the round robin, did not back down from anyone.
Pushing and shoving in the goal crease of Finland, and the goal is off its mooring. So the frustration may be building a little bit now. Bumping in the corner is Siren trying to get possession. Now Dronstand, a loose shot, they score! The United States has taken the lead and drawn first blood here.
Pat LaFontaine comes out from the boards. Is left alone in front when the Finns fail to clear the puck. LaFontaine spins, and the puck is in the net in the first scoring play of Canada Cup 87. The Finns showed some offense after all. Finland wins the faceoff, and from just inside the blue line, Timo Jutila lobs a relatively easy shot behind U.S. goalie John Van Beesbrouck. They avoid being shut out. The U.S. wins this opening game. Their star was Pat LaFontaine, member of the United States Olympic team of 1984 and now with the New York Islanders. No surprise, Kari Kako is the standout performer for the Finns, but even his heroics, Finland would not win a game in the Canada Cup 87.
No score in this hockey game, and things have gotten off to a little bit of a slow start at the Saddle Dome in Calgary. Yeah. Racing in, Tocca, Trichy scores! Number 22, Rick Tocca from the Philadelphia Flyers.
Back comes Czechoslovakia. Drop pass to Pasek, low shot. Blocked, Crossman couldn't clear it. Here's Leva. In front, Pasek, Trichy scores! Dušan Pasek, number 21, ties this game up.
Canada's head coach Mike Keenan was Jean Perron, one of his assistants. They know they're in for some tough hockey before this tournament goes to the record book.
Here's Coffey, getting it to Mario Lemieux.
After swapping two more goals, Canada takes a 4-3 lead on a power play. One power play goal deserves another, however, as the Czechs now have the advantage.
Now to Bolek. Back to Herdina, to Staviana. Over to Herdina. Side of the net to Bolek. He scores! Bolek ties this game up on a pretty passing play. And the power play for Czechoslovakia cashes in.
I think that may have gone off. Hartsburg was at the side of the net. Watch, Hartsburg goes out. I think he put it in his own net.
It came outside the zone. Shot back.
Now pumped up. Czechoslovakia almost takes the lead.
Block shoots. Big save, Pure. On Rostislav Plocka was in alone. And Pure with an excellent glove save.
The reaction. This is strictly reaction on the part of Brent Pure. He's cold. He's got no help. Big save.
Then in the last minute, Canada almost breaks the tie.
On to Brett Gretzky. Waits for the trailer. Prop shooting. Rebound. And it's stopped by Hasek on Tocca. Oh, Canada on a great setup by Gretzky. First.
They finish in a 4-4 tie. Now at Copps Coliseum in Hamilton, Canada meets the U.S., and right from the start, the signs point to a physical game. Bobby Carpenter takes a penalty for pulling down Craig Hartsburg. Here's the hit of the tournament. Watch Rick Tocchet coming in on the right. Phil Housley is flattened on this one. Mario Lemieux and Chris Nyland have this unpleasant exchange. Kevin Dineen will limp off the ice after being run into on the boards on this play.
As he went into the corner on a good, clean hit by Suter, who had a good shift because he caused the turnover in the other end of the ice as well. But look at the problems that Kevin Dineen is having now.
Meanwhile, Pat LaFontaine was the first on the score sheet, jumping on this loose puck. 1-0 USA. Then Canada went to work. Mario Lemieux scoring the first of three.
Big Mario Lemieux scores. This game tied 1-1. And Lemieux gets it to Coffey. To Gretzky closing in. Shoots. Messier failed. Now Lemieux shoots. He scores. Mario Lemieux. He shoots it in. Now Lemieux's going for the net. Now watch the move from behind the net. Back to Bork. Over to Coffey. Into Gretzky.
Get somebody in front.
Here's the pass. Messier was there for the deflection. They score! Mario Lemieux has the hat trick.
Those three goals by Mario Lemieux were all Canada needed, beating the United States 3-2. Back on American soil before a sellout crowd in Hartford, Team USA has more tough work cut out for them as they meet the Soviet Union. It's the only time they'll play each other during the tournament, and the going was anything but easy. How about this hip check by Joe Mullen on Igor Kravchuk? Wayne Pressly gets his man at the U.S. blue line. Ed Olczyk tries to run his opponent through the boards. Even the goalie gets in the act. Watch Tom Barrasso's left arm nearly decapitate the Soviet's Andrei Homotov. The ugliest moment of the tournament. Andrei Lomakin high-sticks Gary Suter. Watch as Suter approaches center ice. The high stick by Lomakin. And Suter retaliates with a vicious slash. Suter takes a five-minute penalty. Lomakin is obviously injured and bleeding. And here's how he looked after they stitched him back together. Soviet coach Viktor Tikhonov was most unhappy at the rough stuff. His men promptly went out and scored on the power play.
About a minute into the second now, as Krutov feeds it in front and it's in. The Soviets quickly pounce on the power play opportunity again. Krutov started the play and Makarov got his stick on it and poked it home for a 2-0 lead.
Trailing in the score, Team USA came fighting back to make a game of it.
Blocked by the Soviet player Homilov and goes loose in the corner. Makarov now to Larionov. He gets a check in front. Here's the shot. It is right on from Wayne Pressly. Rebound, and the play is whistled down, but a dangerous scoring bid there for the United States.
Next period, things went better for the U.S. But even the noisy support of the crowd and winning a stick measurement infraction couldn't save the U.S. The Soviets went on to score three more goals, defeating Team USA 5-1. But that score is not a true indication of the play of the U.S. When they needed it most, especially in the early going, the Soviet defense slammed shut the Americans, left them frustrated and defeated, scoring just one goal. Again, the final score. The Soviets 5, Team USA 1. Sweden came into this Canada Cup as defending world champions. And their first game against the Soviets supported that reputation, although the Soviets scored first.
The Soviets working in across the line. Centering pass right on, they score! Pretty play. Valeri Kaminsky, who put on such a great show at Rendezvous with three goals against the NHL All-Stars last February, gives the Soviets the lead.
But the Swedes fought back. It's 1-1 on this shot from the point.
Back up to the line to Telvin. Long shot right on, they score!
Next, Tommy Albelin gives Sweden a 2-1 lead. Håkan Södergren makes it 3-1 for Sweden on a power play. The Swedes were going wild. But look at this man. Vladimir Krutov is on the move.
Vladimir Krutov on a breakaway. Yastin tries to get back. There's a shot. They score.
Those Soviets never stop. Here's Andrei Homachov with the tying goal. Then Lars Karlsson came back for Sweden after Tommy Eklund's hard shot.
Makarov stopped at the line. Now here's the chance. Right on, he scores! And now we've got
the clinching goal for Sweden comes from Peter Lundström on this breakaway. The Swedes win.
Well, that puts the game away for the Swedes.
The Soviets are in shock, and Tikhanov is not a happy man. Round-robin play continues. Another big crowd at Kops Coliseum for Team Canada and the Soviet Union. There's Mike Keenan, the no-nonsense coach of Team Canada. And right off the bat, Canada's Grant Pure is put to the test.
Svetlov has Lomachen in front. Big save, Pure! On Lomachen and Prop cleared it away.
And going the other way, Glenn Anderson puts Canada ahead 1-0.
Tockett can't get it, but Prop does. And here comes Murphy to Tockett. Kazatonov is there defensively. And now the Soviets drop it back behind their own goal. Kazatonov checked out in front. Backhander, they score! Glenn Anderson, number 9.
There's Vladislav Trajak looking on, one of the best goalies ever to play this game.
Soviets come right back the other way. Lomachen to Semyonov, shooting, side of the net, they score! Tipped in by Svetlov, number 16, as he went cruising by the net. Stelnov, number 4. Stick handling beautifully, leads a Soviet rush to Makarov. Back in front, a shot, they score! Deflected in by Krutov at the side of the net, and the Soviets lead 2-1.
That's what happens when Tikhanov's ahead, but he wants more.
Semyonov carries out of there. Semyonov with Svetlov with him to Svetlov, he scores! Svetlov on a low booming shot. A short-handed goal, and it's 3-1 for the Soviets. Now Messier breaks up. To Mario Lemieux. Big Mario into Gretzky. Gretzky in front. Messier to Gretzky to Bork. They score! Raymond Bork!
Well, Dan, you described it perfectly. Messier to Gretzky to Bork. Boy, that's nice.
Into the third period now. Canada still trailing with overtime less than 3 minutes away.
To Messier. Over to Crossman. Doug Crossman moving in. Centers. Messier fired it in front. Oh, Anderson almost scored. A shot, they score!
Struggle. It hit the post first, right behind him. Good effort there, but it went right through, hit the post right there. Now it goes in. Crossman got it.
Well, I don't know if Crossman got it or did Gretzky put it in before Crossman got there.
All right, we'll watch it again. Gretzky going for the net there. Here it comes. Anderson reaches out, throws it in there. Now it's lying loose. It was Gretzky who got the goal. Crossman was there, but Gretzky...
There's no overtime in the round robin. And that's the way the game ended, in a 3-3 tie. With play moving on in the Canada Cup, every game becomes more critical. And no game was more important to Team USA than when they met Czechoslovakia in Sydney, Nova Scotia. Rod Langway and his teammates knew they had to win or miss the tournament playoffs. Bob Johnson is coaching the Americans. Jan Starcy is behind the Czech bench. But it's on the ice where it counts most. And Czechoslovakia hit the scoreboard first.
Way past Chelios. Here's a chance for Van Hagel. He scores. And now.
Early in the second period, the U.S. gets a break as the Czechs give up the puck at their own blue line. It's promptly picked up by Chris Nyland, and he just blows it by Dominik Hašek, the Czech goaltender.
Nyland takes that puck and just ends up blasting it just inside that post. Wayne Pressly.
Team USA continues to put on the pressure.
LaFontaine behind the net. It comes back out towards the line. Gary Suter shoots. There's a deflection right in front. A backhand shot by LaFontaine. Czechs moving the puck around effectively.
Try as they might, the Americans never scored again. The Czechs have a man advantage.
Bozsik from the line. There's a chance. Oh, and Van Beesbrouck just saw it at the last minute and deflected it over top of the net. Banak, Bozsik. Here's another shot. Ready to score!
That goal took the steam out of the USA as Czechoslovakia wins 3-1. Team USA misses the playoffs. The Czechs move on. The Montreal Forum saw one of the round-robin favorite games, Canada against the world champion Swedes. This game is less than 2 minutes old when Wayne Gretzky scores his first tournament goal on a power play.
Gretzky shoots, he scores! Wayne Gretzky! Here it comes.
You can't win without great goaltending. Grant Fuhr at one end.
What a save. Now it bounces loose.
And Peter Lindmark in the Swedish goal.
And Gretzky shoots. Low save, Lindmark. For
Albelin, number three. Sweden then tied the score on a goal by Bent Gustafsson and then went ahead on this effort.
Mikael Andersson dropping it back in front. Pettersson scores. Number 21, Lars Gunnar Pettersson left alone in the slot. And Sweden has the lead.
But Gretzky quickly teams up with Mario Lemieux to tie it 2-2.
Mario Lemieux! Ron, they were both there, Messier and Lemieux, but I think it was Lemieux that put it in.
And then the winning goal. Again, Gretzky is the architect, and Lemieux finishes the job.
Fakes it, goes in deeper to Lemieux.
Not surprisingly, Wayne Gretzky is named player of the game. Canada wins 5-3. Sweden would fare better against the Czechs thanks to some hard forechecking, first in one corner, then on the far side, as the Czechs cough up the puck and Anders Eldebrink dances in to score for Sweden. Sweden keeps up the forechecking, and soon the Czechs are grasping at anything to get back into this game. But Eklund drives in the final nail as the Swedes shut out Czechoslovakia 4-0. And that has even coach Tommy Sandlin smiling with satisfaction. Six countries were invited to the Labatt Canada Cup 87. The United States and Finland came up short in round-robin play. They have been eliminated, leaving the top four in two sudden-death semifinal matches. Canada will face Czechoslovakia at the Montreal Forum in one semifinal. The Kops Coliseum is the scene of the other semifinal, the Soviet Union versus Sweden. When the Soviets met the Swedes, they exchanged more than gifts when play got underway.
The Swedes with Mats Näslund back for Makarov. He's decked as he moved out, and there's going to be a penalty here against Sweden. It's over the line, Carlson, and he is
While all this heavy hitting was going on, the Soviets quietly went about scoring goals.
Trying to make the little deke is Bekov, and he goes flying.
Soviets with the man advantage. Fetisov at the point. To Kasatonov. Shoots one, deflected. Rebound, a poke at it. Krutov scores. Krutov. And the Swedes are arguing that play should have been called, but I believe the goal by Krutov will stand.
But here's the first shot. Down it goes. Now it lies loose there. He got a glove on it, but he couldn't hold it. The argument was that he got it in his glove, but definitely not. That's the fifth goal scored by Krutov in the tournament. So he's right there with Mario Lemieux right now. Here again, as the shot comes in from the far point. Good save right here. And then he reached back, got his glove on it, but couldn't hold it.
One of the Swedish players, Anderson, has lost his stick. Anderson trying to get his stick back. Soviets get the puck. Krutov shot. Bekov a drive. He scores! Number 27, Bekov. And it's 2-0 for the Soviet Union.
In Vienna last year, Sweden was down 2-0 in the game against the Soviets. In the medal round, came back and tied that game with a minute and a half left at 2-2. And went on to beat Canada and win the world championship.
Here's Larionov making it 3-0. Power play goal by Larionov. Naslund cutting in, centered off a skate, and then cleared away by Fetisov. Loose puck and a breakaway for the Soviets, and a big save by Lindmark. As Krutov got a loose puck and walked in alone, and Lindmark had to come up very big. Krutov came from nowhere to get that breakaway. Number 20 is Anders Carlson on the boards for Södergren. Back behind the net, Carlson to Södergren. Flipped it right through the goal crease, but nobody there to get a stick on it. Now, Bergqvist center, Södergren shot. The rebound, they score! Flying flat on the ice, and getting a stick on it was Bergqvist.
Just reaching behind him and just getting a stick. You're right, Dan. That was the only thing he could do. And I think he had a little bit of luck going for him. Either that or some of the greatest eye-hand coordination you've ever seen. The puck came out from the corner and a good shot. And it got away from Milnikov. Now watch, he reaches out and boom. Never give up on it. That's the old line. Just reached back. There was a loose puck directly in front of the crease and he knocked it in.
Now Krutov breaks away, feeding Larionov, who's open. Shoots, Lindmark comes out, makes the save. Drop pass back, Fetisov to Makarov. He scores! Makarov left alone at the side of the net. Deflects in, Fetisov shot from the point. Here's Rundqvist behind the net for Sweden on the power play. To Anderson, back to the point, they score!
That goal brought the score to 4-2 for the Soviets, and that's the way it ended. Soviet Union 4, Sweden 2.
Here by the Soviet Union, who will advance to the Canada Cup final against either Canada or Czechoslovakia.
The Forum in Montreal, Czechoslovakia versus Canada, sudden death semifinal, and Team Canada tries to strike early.
Here's Canada with Bork at the point. Dropping it back to Larry Murphy, centered it across to Anderson. Shot right on, dropped the rebound. And Hoshek flat on the ice, just able to get his leg on it and freeze it there. Big, big chance there for Canada, their best of the game.
Well, all of the predictions are holding forth here. The goaltending, very good in the first period. Hoshek here, watch his movement in the goal mouth. Down in that butterfly style. Now he seems out of position, but the big leg is out there.
Now Chajka into Pashek. That's Goulet tying him up. Chajka pinching in from the point. Firing it around behind the net. Shava centered. Oh, Pashek shoots. He scores! Dusan Pashek, and it's 1-0 for Czechoslovakia.
Going back now.
Canada soon realized they had to use some muscle. Mark Messier messes with number 4, Horshava. Claude Lemieux leaves his calling card. The frustrations around the Czechoslovakian goal continued to eat at the Canadians' decorum, and at times the tempers wore thin.
And then Stabiana gets a headlock on one of the Team Canada players, Brent Sutter in the crease.
Meanwhile, the Czechs take a 2-0 lead.
Here's Leba. Gets turned around looking for a man. They score!
from the point. A blast by Pienaar, number 9. Actually, Chajka let it go, and it's 2-0 for Czechoslovakia. Now Goulet.
Canada would wait until the game's halfway point before launching their come from behind heroics.
Shoot the score! Now, Howardchuk will have to kick this one up in front, get set, and then let the screen shot go that deflected off the defenseman and into the net.
Mike Keenan now has his players back in a positive frame of mind. And with hard work and close checking, the chances come.
So the explanation apparently was accepted. Here's Mario Lemieux in the clear. He scores! Here's Messier. Couldn't get around Bonac, and now it's Coffey into Gretzky. In on left wing to Bork. Mario Lemieux. He scores!
Less than 2 minutes later, it would be Mario Lemieux scoring again, this time giving Canada the lead.
It's a little drop pass. Here's Bork. Lemieux going for the net. Doesn't take much to score. Just have to get your stick on it and redirect. He scores them all ways. And it's 3-2 on two straight goals by Mario Lemieux.
Goulet broke that up and back jumped Canada. Sutter to Gretzky with Goulet. Pass to Goulet. He scores!
Breakaway pass, and here is a break for Golak.
But the Czechs haven't quit yet.
Golak from Herdina. Both of Team Canada's defensemen got caught up ice, and it was a two-man breakaway for Czechoslovakia.
And all of a sudden, we're back into a one-goal hockey game.
Canada 4, Czechoslovakia 3. Sudden death semifinal. Sutter feeding it into Lemieux. Mario Lemieux moves in, shoots, rebound, he scores! Brian Brock!
Forget about Brian Brock. How about Mario Lemieux? Look at this move.
Two goals down, 2 minutes to play. Czechoslovakia couldn't come back. And Canada wins the semifinal sudden death 5-3. And it will advance to the best of three final. It opened with game one at the Montreal Forum. The Labatt Canada Cup 87 final series, Canada versus the Soviet Union. And for the first time, a Canadian referee has been requested by the Soviets. He's Don Koharski.
Here we go with Gretzky against Larionov. Game one is underway, and Bork fires it off the boards down into the Soviet zone. Wide of the net, Gartner in to chop at the rebound, but couldn't get it, and Samak feeding it into center ice for Lomaka, number 23. He's upended by Rochefort, number 5. And this is Rochefort carrying to Mario Lemieux. Into Gartner. Shoot, he scores! Mike Gartner! Nasatonov's pass into center ice, picked up on the fly by Samak.
flowering it in for Lomachen. He couldn't get it. Now on the board, Semyonov, number 30. Back to Petisov, to Kasatonov. Shoots, he scores! Deflected on the way through. Kasatonov let it go, but it changed directions. This game is tied 1-1. Here's Makarov. Back to Petisov in front. Larionov couldn't get his stick on the pass. Here's Makarov to Petisov. Shot, Fuhr the save. Rebound, Krutov scores! Krutov! Two power play goals by the Soviets, and the Soviets take a 2-1 lead.
Two more goals by the Soviets made it 4-1 as we near the end of the second period. Canada is working on a power play, trying to get back in this hockey game.
Gretzky leaving it for Bork. Shot, they score! Deflected in, and Canada scores on the power play.
Watch the nifty pass from Gretzky to Bork, and the puck is deflected in front of the Soviet goal. It's 4-2 going into period three.
Here's Krutov to Larionov, cutting in. Larionov, and a diving glove save on the short side by Grant Fuhr. That may have been a game saver right there as Larionov made a couple of nifty moves. Gusarov going back for the Soviets. That's Gilmour into forecheck. Gilmour stole it, but Lemieux couldn't get it. Now Hartsberg is shot. Here's Gilmour chipping it in behind the net. Gardner in front. Gilmour shoots. He scores! Doug Gilmour cuts the Soviet lead to 4-3.
Soviet coach Tikhanov is upset. His club has just been given a penalty for too many men on the ice. Mike Keenan has a power play.
Soviets trying to protect the one-goal lead. Here's Messier into Anderson. Shoots, he scores!
Now, 3 minutes remaining in regulation time. Canada keeps the pressure on. It's tied 4-4.
Now Bork at the point. Shoots wide. Gretzky the rebound. He scores! Wayne Gretzky for Canada! Shot. Fuhr got a piece of that. Here's Bekov. Gretzky trying to tie him up. Bekov centered. And in front they score! And the Soviets come back to tie this game up. A similar goal that Gretzky just scored on a pass out that was just tipped in, and I think it was Holmatov.
That's Bork. Up in front of the net, and I think it went off his skate. We'll see how they score it, but we've got a 5-5 tie now.
Frostman scooping it in, Goulet charging in after it. Takes his man out, Semyonov trying to clear it. Bork held it in, gets it to Lemieux. Now to Goulet, for Bukin, center to Lemieux, shoots. Oh, Melnikov got the left hand out in a flash there. And that's a game saver.
There's the shot. Gardner waiting for anything that might be left over. He knew where he was shooting it. May have liked to get it a little higher.
Soviets, Bekov breaking up. Bekov moving in. Shoots, Fuhr a save. Murphy the rebound. And he cleared it away. Lemieux behind the net with 12 seconds left. To Coffey, held in by Podotov. He centered one, but Kamensky had been knocked down in the play, and now Lemieux, with 3 seconds left, clears it to center, and we are going to have sudden death overtime to decide a winner here. After regulation time, it is Canada 5, the Soviet Union 5. Coffey flipping it into center ice. Intercepting it there, Gusarov to Larionov, now into Makarov, in behind Coffey. Makarov shoots. Big save, pure rebound. Larionov is stopped by Coffey. And that's the best chance yet for either team. Anderson stick handling in. Anderson shot into the corner to Howardchuk. Tried to get it in front. Knocked away, and Petisov has it for the Soviets. Petisov into center ice. To Lomakin. Samyanov to Samak. He scores! Samak into the top corner. And the Soviets win in overtime. 6-5. Alexander Samak with the winning goal.
What a great shot by Samak. Picking the top corner on the glove side, but a great play coming out to strength of Petisov, and then he looked one way, gave the pass the other. Now Samak will get the pass over the line. They just slip it through, and here's the shot. Right off the crossbar and in to end what has been just a classic hockey game.
Samak, who's normally a center, moved to right wing because of the injury to Svetlov, and he proves to be the hero of the night for the Soviets.
Semyonov with that play in his skates as he seemed to corral the puck beautifully and then give it to Samak. Boy, what a shot, though. You just nothing that Fuhrer could do at all.
Samak with the winning goal, and the Soviets lead this best of three series 1-0. Game two coming up at the Cops Coliseum. And away we go in Hamilton. Messier getting it over to Howardchuk, now back to Rochefort, to Crossman. Ahead on right wing to Glenn Anderson, who fires it in. Petisov back to get it. That's Howardchuk into forecheck, but Kasatonov clears it out to Krutop, number 9. He just tipped it to center. Back over for Petisov. Spins from Howardchuk, gets it to Makarov, to Larionov. Centered, big save pure early here on that great try by the Soviets. Back is Howardchuk to Messier, cutting in. Messier centered, Rochefort scores! Rochefort!
How long Rochefort ever scored a bigger goal? What a play as he came in. Watch number 5, he'll move in. He'll be the extra man in the zone. They were not ready for him.
Quite a play by Messier to set it up.
Oh, just great. There it comes again. Now everybody's tied up in front, and Rochefort is the extra man.
Stelnov feeding Omotop, number 15. Omotop moving in. Shoots one up high as it hit a stick. Bekov in front. Omotop scores on the rebound. Andre Omotop, number 15, ties it up. Back comes Gretzky. Gilmore back out of the penalty box. Canada carrying in. Rochefort to Gilmore. To the stars! Doug Gilmore! And Canada leads 2-1. Here's Gretzky to Coffey. Coffey shoots one. In behind, double shaking. Reaches back and grabbed it. They pour it across the red line. And Bellows shaken. Looks rather shaky here in the opening period. And back comes Bekov. Bekov in for the Soviets, leaving it for Semyonov. They drop it back to Kasatonov. Shoots, hit the post. Big rebound, Kasatonov stopped by Fuhrer. Canada can't clear it. Now, two of the penalized players back on. Petisov, a shot deflected, and then poked away by Rochefort. Petisov holding it in to Semyonov. Shooting, and Fuhrer, a stick save there. Here's Nemchinov, back to Petisov. A drive, back to flex wide. Bekov, Soviets on a power play, 35 seconds left in Messier's penalty. Bekov to Semyonov, he scores! No goal, says the referee. No goal, I think a man in the crease. Gretzky to Gartner. front to Gretzky. Gets it to Coffey, right hand, he turns. He scores! Paul Coffey! Here's Makarov, and Coffey headed him off. Speed against speed. Here's Makarov to Krutov. He moves and scores! Short-handed goal! And that's the Soviets' third in three games against Canada. And it ties it at 3-3. Bekov with Homotov now leaving it there. And Bork cleared it, and here's Gretzky with Lemieux. Two-on-one break. Gretzky to Lemieux. Scores!
Thought, but he's got the two greatest forwards in the game today coming at him. What are you going to do? Not much you can do. Watch it go by.
Kaminsky into center ice to Homotov. Homotov moving in to Bekov, back and he scores! Bekov ties this game at 4-4.
Great backhand shot, always the most difficult shot for a goaltender to handle because of the angle it comes off the stick.
Here's Mario Lemieux, back to Bork, shot deflects, comes to Gretzky. Gretzky to Bork, side of the net to Lemieux. Back to Bork again, over to Coffey, Coffey to Lemieux. Back to Bork, to Coffey, shoots, fellow shaking the save, rebound, they score! .120 left in regulation time. Here's Bekov. Gets to center. Trying to clear it. Gretzky back checking. Got it to Gilmore. Gilmore flipped it into center ice. Here's Kamienski trying to break through. Shoots. He scores! Kamienski with a brilliant goal. Ties this game up with 1:04 left.
Oh, what a goal. The defense didn't play the man on this. They got backing in, and Kaminsky just got between. Rush for it. I think it was Crossman in there, but this great speed, and he just got a little bit of a march. Tried to tackle him.
Came with 1:04 left in regulation time. Now Gilmore for Canada. 8 seconds left. Flipping it in. Patisov there to wind it around on the boards. And it's Krutov clearing the center. We will have sudden death overtime for the second game in a row in this final series between the Soviets and Canada. And credit a brilliant move by Valery Kamienski to tie it with 1:04 to play and send it into overtime. Coffey breaks it up over to Goulet. Goulet for Canada, giving it to Gretzky in front to Lemieux. Rebound, Gretzky. It's knocked off the puck. And Kasatonov has it for the Soviets to Makarov. Mario Lemieux for Canada. Flips it back in. Batisov there to pick it up. Now up to Larionov. Ed Manning at the Kasatonov. Soviets move in. Here's a chance. Centered. Cure makes a rebound. Cure stopped that too from Krutov, who twice just about ended this game.
Oh, the defense got caught, and I think that the Soviets can be accused of getting a little too fancy on the play. Krutov had their best chance. Here we come. Kazatonov. There's the pass across the goal mouth by Larionov when he might have been able to shoot himself, and then the backhand shot with Fuhr down. But Fuhr never seems to lose track of the puck. Even down, he's looking at it, concentrating, and knocking it out of midair and putting his glove on it.
No scoring in period one of overtime, and we'll have to wait for a second overtime period to decide a game winner in game two. The shots on goal in overtime, the Soviets 12, Canada 9. And it's still tied 5-5.
Here's Raymond Bork.
Bork into Gretzky. Gretzky cutting in. Centers to Lemieux. Shot it wide. Drops behind the net. Out to Murphy. Murphy to Gretzky. Hit the post. Rebound. They score! Mario Lemieux! Canada wins. The series is tied.
Tonight's game is the third and last of the finals between Team Soviet Union and Team Canada.
And every time you see Larionov out there, you usually see Messier against him, and that's the way we start. Kurutov in across the line for Makarov. Centering pass, Messier back-checking, gets it to Gretzky. Behind the back pass for Lemieux, but it's shot out of there by Fetisov. Now to Larionov. Larionov leaving it for Makarov. He's checked by Lemieux from behind. Now Krutov closing in. Gretzky checked him from behind. And Gretzky winds it around. Center. They score! Makarov all alone in front of the net. Set up by Krutov. And an early goal for the Soviets.
Doug Crossman at the side of the net let the puck come to him rather than going after the puck and found himself beaten to it. Gretzky clearing it around the net. Crossman is number two as Gretzky is decked.
And the Soviets lead 1-0. 6 minutes later, Team Canada has a man advantage, but it doesn't go according to the book.
The slot. Soviets clear it, knocked down by Hartsburg. To Gretzky. In front, Goulet upended in the slot. And Gusarov comes out of there. 2-on-1, Soviet break, copy trying to get back. Here's the shot, off the goalpost. Oh, and Gusarov, now they put the red light on. I think it went in the net. Gusarov indicated he had scored, but the red light did not come on. Then it did. And let's see what Koharski rules here.
As you can see, Koharski has no choice. As the puck hits the post, then the back of the net. Soviets 2-0. Less than a minute later, the Soviets threatened to run away with the game.
Here's Makarov. Makarov beating Fetisov, closing in. Gretzky scores! Fetisov from Makarov. It's 3-0 for the Soviets.
Mark Messier on the far side getting in a little too quickly. The penalty to Kravchuk at 9-10 for cross-checking.
Canada with the man advantage. Bork and Murphy, the point men, with Anderson, Goulet, and Tocchet up front. Puck dumped in by Bork. Now Anderson digs in against Fetisov. Makarov there to clear it. Knocked down by Canada. Here's Murphy. Shoots, field to cut the same rebound. Tocchet scores!
Time there was no finesse at all. Murphy again gets it in the slot. This time he elected to shoot. It got behind Molnikov, and Tkachuk, trailing on the play, picked up the loose puck.
Now here's Bork from center ice firing it in. Back to Steldo. Into Portek is Tkachuk. Rick Tkachuk. Gets some help from Brent Sutter out in front. They score! Brian Tkachuk tips it in. Bork with 49 seconds left in the penalty to Coffey. Stick save, Milnikov. Gretzky to Coffey. Over to Lemieux. Couldn't handle a pass. To Messier, who lets it go to Gretzky. On the point to Bork. Over to Coffey. Now to Bork with 30 seconds left in the penalty. Back to Coffey. Over to Gretzky. Soviets playing that box. Side of the net to Messier. Back to Gretzky. Now to Coffey. Shooting. Milnikov save. And Mario Lemieux couldn't get the rebound. Now he does. To Messier. Messier shoots from a bad angle. Mazatonov blocked that. We're in the final minute of the period. 4 seconds left of the penalty. Gretzky to Coffey. Over to Bork. Penalized player back on. Bork lets the shot go. Block. And Kurutov cleared it. Now Bork a shot. Gretzky deflects. Off the goal post for that one. And the Soviets, Makarov clearing the center. Bork back to get it. Bork loses. Kolmatov in the clear. Scores! Kolmatov on a breakaway. And the Soviets on a late goal take a 4-2 lead here in the first period.
But moving to the second period, Canada would rock the Soviets with 3 unanswered goals.
Back of the net to Gretzky. In front to Murphy. Shoots. He scores!
I'll play with it. Shoot it.
Less than 2 minutes later, Canada ties the score after some scrambly play at center ice.
Now Fedotov trying to set up Kamensky. Back comes Crossman for Canada, trying to beat it up to Goulet. Goulet on the left wing boards. Slides it around. Into the corner goes Crossman. Now to Howardchuk. Dale Howardchuk, center to shot. They score! Brent Sutter ties this game up!
The key to this is look at the traffic in front of the net. Out comes the pass. Couldn't put it in a better spot.
Canada comes back to tie it at 4-4. The Soviets at one time led 3-0. Now Makarov, back of the net, gets it back from Fetisov. Makarov for Kurutov. He's checked. Canada clear it. Soviets hold it in, but now carried up by Murphy. As Howardchuk and Sutter with him. To Howardchuk, shoots. Milnikov the save. Howardchuk back of the net, stuffs it in front. Shoots, he scores! Dale Howardchuk!
The shot is going to go off the goaltender, Milnikov. Here comes Sutter. He's going to take the puck away. Creates the turnover. Howardchuk, one chance. Comes back out to him. Second shot into the net. And Canada, for the first time, has the lead. His fourth goal of the tournament, Dale Howardchuk.
Soviet coaches Dmitriev and Tikhonov try to figure out how these Canadians keep coming back. But the Soviets can do it too. They trail 5-4, third period, final game.
Now to Semyonov, number 30. Over to Samak, moving in, trying to get up to Lomakin. Howardchuk had him tied up, now center to shot, they score! Samak ties this game up with 7:39 left in regulation time.
So what else is new? A 5-5 tie.
1:36 left in regulation time, and a face-off deep in Team Canada's end of the rink.
Well, now it's hold on time.
Howardchuk wins it in. Here's Here's Lemieux poking at the center. Lemieux ahead to Gretzky. Has Murphy with him on a 2-on-1 to Lemieux. And on goal, he shoots, he scores! Mario Lemieux with 1:26 remaining. Soviets, copy back with 20 seconds left, and Canada clear it out.